The decision has a big effect on K-State and KU as well. Karen Kornacki has spent the afternoon on the campus in Lawrence.
Here in Lawrence, it's hard to tell what KU thinks to the news that the Big 12 will stay intact. As you can tell, things are kind of quiet right now. It is summertime, but it is business as usual on campus. Bill Self is holding his basketball camp this week, and his players have been putting on quite a show for the kids. We'll hear from Bill and football coach Turner Gill in just a few minutes. Other coaches are breathing a sigh of relief, especially when it comes to travel, because right now the Midwest is a very tight-knit group. You can see here the volleyball schedule. The team didn't have to travel far, but if the Pac-10 had come calling and they had gone, it would have been a whole different story.
And it affected everybody differently. I mean, the ACC for soccer is the best conference there is. The Pac-10 in volleyball is one of the top conferences. So just depending on the sport, everybody kind of had a different take on it. You know, our softball coach saw Arizona and UCLA playing for the national championship, two Pac-10 schools, and she thought, oh my goodness.
Students on campus seemed to take the news really well. They were glad to keep the rivalries alive. But they did admit to me that they now think about Texas in a whole different way.
You know, last couple days, I've never been a Texas fan, but I'm actually happy that they're staying together, and I think they're doing the right thing.
Are you bitter against Texas, though?
I think I was, but not anymore, since they kind of saved the Big 12 now. So I have to be thankful for them, but I still don't really like Texas.
And that's what good rivalries are made of. In Lawrence, Karen Kornacki, KNBC 9 Sports.